You can also contrast configuration with case-based reasoning. Both configuration and case-based reasoning are typically applicable to routine design problems, problems of the kind that we have often encountered in the past. In case of configuration, we start with a prototypical concept, then assign values to all the variables, as we saw in this chair example. In case of case-based reasoning, we start with the design of a specific chair that we had designed earlier, look at its variables, and tweak it as needed to satisfy these constraints of the current problem. Case-based reasoning assumes that we already designed a lot of chairs and we have stored examples of the chairs we have designed in the memory. Configuration assumes that we already designed enough chairs so that we can in fact abstract a plan hierarchy out of them. When a specific problem is presented to an AI agent, the AI agent, if it is going to use the method of configuration, is going to call upon that plan abstraction hierarchy and then start refining plans. If the agent uses the method of case-based reasoning, then it will go into the case memory, retrieve the closest matching case, and then start tweaking the case. A little bit later, we will see how an AI agent may select between different methods available to address a task. As we have mentioned earlier in the course, the chemical periodic table was one of the really important scientific discoveries. Similar to the chemical periodic table, we are trying to build a periodic table of intelligence. Unlike the chemical periodic table, which deals with balanced electrons, our periodic table of intelligence deals with tasks and methods. In this particular course, we have considered both a large number of tasks, configuration being one of them, as well as a large number of methods, plan instantiation and case-based reasoning being two of them.